Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab Series on Current Sense Amplifiers. My name is Kyle Stone, and I am a product marketing engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will take a closer look at offset error, which is caused by an amplifier's input offset voltage. In previous videos, we introduced the root sum of squares, or RSS, total error equation for current sense amplifier circuits, as shown here. Note that some error terms may not be shown. The next few topics will focus on input referred offset error sources, input offset voltage, VOS, common mode rejection ratio, CMRR, or power supply rejection ratio, PSRR. All three of these errors are given in the electrical characteristics table on a device datasheet, as shown here. The rest of this video focuses on VOS, as well as VOS drift. VOS drift describes the change of VOS with ambient temperature. Input offset voltage, or VOS, is defined as the DC voltage that must be applied between the amplifier input terminals to force the DC output voltage to zero. An amplifier's ideal VOS is 0 volts. Process variation and device design constraints, however, cause non-zero values of VOS. VOS adds to VIN and has an impact on the accuracy of a current sense amplifier circuit, especially at low inputs, as we will soon illustrate. The equation to calculate offset error is shown here. It is simply the ratio of the maximum VOS to the ideal shunt voltage. V shunt ideal is the product of the load current and ideal shunt resistor value. Ignoring the tolerance and temperature drift of the resistor itself, which will be discussed in later videos. Input offset voltage is typically the largest factor affecting a solution's accuracy at low inputs. This is because V shunt ideal becomes very small, to the point where VOS is very large by comparison. You can see an example of this in the error plot on the right. Minimizing this error is often the most important requirement for current sensing circuits. Let's calculate the offset error in an example system with a minimum load current of 5 amps and an ideal shunt resistance of 1 milliohm. We will pick the INA195 as our amplifier, which has a maximum VOS of 2 millivolts. The ideal shunt voltage is equal to our load current times our shunt resistor, which results in 5 millivolts. Using our offset error equation from before, we calculate that the error is a whopping 40%. This is not a very useful measurement. The first thing most engineers will ask is, how do we make it better and minimize offset error? There are two possible ways to approach this. First, you can increase the shunt voltage, which means increasing the shunt resistance. Second, you can decrease the offset voltage, which requires selecting a different device. Increasing the shunt resistance may or may not be feasible due to cost, board space, or power dissipation concerns. Let's consider option 2, selecting a different device with a lower VOS. Now we will consider the INA190, which has a max VOS of only 15 microvolts, or 0.015 millivolts. The application conditions for load current and shunt resistance are the same as before. Recalculating offset error gives a new result of only 0.3%. As you can see, the INA190 is a much better choice for this application. It is important to note that offset error should be calculated at minimum input current, since that is the worst case condition when V shunt ideal is the smallest. Finally, let's consider the effects that temperature has on input offset voltage and offset error. In most amplifier data sheets, VOS is specified at room temperature or 25 degrees C. If we want to analyze VOS over temperature, we must consider VOS drift as well. Drift is shown in the electrical characteristics table as D, VOS over DT, or a change in VOS proportional to a change in temperature. Let's calculate the total VOS of the INA 190 at an ambient temperature of 125 degrees C using the equations shown here. We first add the room temperature VOS as before, but now add an extra term which multiplies the drift value by the change in temperature relative to 25 degrees C. Plugging in our 100 degree C difference and 80 nanovolt per degree C drift, we get an additional offset of 8 microvolts and a total VOS of 23 microvolts. Calculating offset error as we did before gives a new result of 0.46% compared to our previous result at room temperature of 0.3%. This is a small increase. This is because the INA 190 is designed with zero drift architecture that preserves its excellent offset performance over temperature. Other devices may have different results. Let's take a minute to summarize what we learned in this video. Number 1, input offset voltage, or VOS, is defined as the DC voltage that must be applied between the amplifier input terminals to force the DC output voltage to zero. Number 2, to calculate offset error, take the ratio of VOS max to the ideal shunt voltage. Number 3, to minimize offset error, you can either increase V shunt by increasing R shunt or decrease VOS by selecting a different device. Number 4. Offset error usually dominates total RSS error at low input signals, since VOS can become large compared to low input voltages. Number 5. For ambient temperatures other than 25 degrees C, offset drift must be considered. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/current sense.